Lots of millennials, have you ever wondered why there are 21 million bitcoins? And have you ever wondered why there are 100 million Satoshis in one bitcoin? Those are the questions that we are going to try to answer today. But first of all, did you also know that I have a free Discord channel for you to join? If you go to nesami.com/discord, leave your name and email address, you'll get access to it. And did you also know that I make short 1-minute videos with news about the stock market called Stock O'Clock? Check them out. Let's first of all briefly talk about why there is a fixed amount of Bitcoin and why it is very unlikely, not impossible, to create more than 21 million Bitcoin. It has to do, according to many people, with the so-called M2 money supply. What does that mean? Well, you have the M1 money supply, the M2 money supply. M1 money supply is basically cash and cash or checking deposits rather. And M2 money supply is a little bit broader than that. According to Investopedia, it says that, well, M2 includes M1 money supply, so cash and checking deposits, but it also includes saving deposits, money market securities, mutual funds, and other time deposits. So these things are a little bit less liquid, but these things can still be quickly converted into cash or checking deposits, right? So basically what you then get is M2 is simply cash or things you can quickly turn into cash. The M2 money supply is a very big and important indicator of the money supply in the world, in the United States, for example, but it's also an indicator of possible future inflation. Okay, that is going to be quite important because, as we're going to see in 2020, last year, a lot of money was created, was printed by the Federal Reserve. So here we have a graph of the M2 money supply in the United States alone, right? And you can see it's generally, well, sort of a flat line, not entirely flat, but it goes up very slightly. We see a little bit of a bump in 2008 after the financial crisis, of course. But then in 2020, so last year, we saw an increasing amount of money printing going on in the United States. If we zoom in a little bit, let's go to 2020. We can see that at the start of 2020, there was around $15.3 trillion of M2 money supply. All right. And if you look at the end of 2020, you can see that that had gone up to about $19.1 trillion in M2 money supply. So basically, about $3.8 trillion was added in just 1 year. $3.8 trillion added in just 1 year. Let's just pull up a calculator to see how much that is compared to the current total M2 money supply, right? So 3.8, and we said that the end of 2020 had $19.1 trillion in M2 money supply. So that basically means that 20% of the entire M2 money supply is created in 2020. So according to many Bitcoiners, this is one of the major reasons why Bitcoin has a capped amount of Bitcoins available in the future, right? There are going to be 21 million Bitcoins. In theory, you could add more Bitcoin, but it's very unlikely. I believe you need 51% of the miners to agree with an increase in the amount of Bitcoin. But yeah, I believe there are like 1 million miners out there. So it's very difficult to get everyone on the same side. There has to be a very, very good reason in order to increase the Bitcoin supply. Then let's talk about those questions of why there are 21 million Bitcoins and why there are 100 million Satoshis in one Bitcoin, right? Well, as you can see on this website, you can see many of the emails that were sent by Satoshi Nakamoto to early Bitcoin adopters, early Bitcoin developers as well. This is an email from Satoshi Nakamoto, and well, no one knows his or her real name, but maybe it's Satoshi Nakamoto, maybe it's something else. But this email was sent from Satoshi to a guy called Mike Hearn. Mike Hearn was one of the earliest Bitcoin users out there, and he also became a Bitcoin developer for about 5 years of his life, right? So if we scroll down a little bit, we can see that Satoshi said the following: "My choice for the number of coins and the distribution schedule was an educated guess. I wanted to pick something that would make prices similar to existing currencies." So this is a very interesting comment because at the time of Bitcoin's creation, the entire world's money supply, which was the M1 money supply, so the cash and checking deposits, stood at approximately $21 trillion. $21 trillion. So if you take that number, $21 trillion, divided by the amount of Bitcoin, which is 21 million, then you would get an amount of Bitcoin or an amount of dollars per Bitcoin of $1 million per Bitcoin. How insane is that? And that's also funny because if one Bitcoin is $1 million, then how much would be one Satoshi? Because remember, there are 100 million Satoshis in one Bitcoin, right? So basically, then you would need to take that $1 million divided by 100 million, and then you would notice that one Satoshi would equal 1 cent. So that could be the reason why there are 21 million Bitcoins and why there are 100 million Satoshis in one Bitcoin. The second reason has to do with math. The thing is, a Bitcoin cycle takes about 4 years in time. After each cycle, the reward that miners get for mining a block on the Bitcoin blockchain is taken down by 50%, right? Right now, miners get 6.25 Bitcoin per block mined. So the thing is, each new block is added around every 10 minutes, right? Every 10 minutes. So if it's every 10 minutes, how many blocks are added in 1 hour? 6, right? Cool. So how many blocks are added in 1 day? Well, you take that 6 and you multiply it by 24. How many days are in a year? 365. So you take that amount of blocks, multiply by 365. How many years were there in one cycle? 4. So you take that amount of blocks, multiply by 4. If you do that, if you go through that entire calculation, you're going to end up with about 210,000 blocks that are created in a cycle of 4 years. So 210,000 blocks in one Bitcoin cycle, right? But let's now talk about those Bitcoin rewards, because I just said, well, each miner gets 6.25 Bitcoin per block mined. That started out at 50 at Bitcoin's creation. Then 4 years later, it went down to 25. 4 years later, it went down to 12.5. So it keeps getting halved each 4 years. Now in 2140, rather, all the Bitcoins are going to be mined. And the funny thing is, if you take 50 and add 25, add 12.5, add 6.25, etc., 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 you're going to arrive at 100, right? So we now have 210 blocks created each Bitcoin cycle of 4 years, and we have a sum of 100 Bitcoins in rewards created, right? So if you multiply those 100 times 210,000, you're also going to arrive at 21 million. Now, just a little side note here, because I just said in 2140, all the Bitcoins are going to be mined, right? But you might have noticed that we are going to be very close to 100% already within a few decades already. If you look, for example, at the year 2036, about 99% of the older Bitcoins in existence in the future are going to be mined. And after that, the additional increases of Bitcoins is just very, very slow. So in 2040, we're already going to have 20.9 million Bitcoin. So there you go. Maybe there are going to be 21 million Bitcoin because of that M1 money supply back when Bitcoin was created. Or maybe it's because of the math behind the amount of blocks created during a cycle and the sum of all the Bitcoin rewards. Now, all of these are just theories, of course. Only the real Satoshi Nakamoto is going to know this. Now, if you found this video helpful, please consider sharing it with your friends who are also interested in Bitcoin. And with that being said, thank you very much for taking the time to watch this video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.